Today, we will be talking about the 2D animation. So, this is the image that we are going to be working with. Okay? His name is Jambu. Hello, Jambu. Hello. How are you? Say hi to the people. Come on, say hi. Wait.
Hi. Hi.
This is Jambu. And this is how he's going to look. The final result in which we are going to be able to turn his hands, legs, head, and everything. But this is not how we are going to work with him. No. Okay. So, let's see. First of all, we start with a sketch. From there, we draw in separate drawings, separate layers. The left arm, the right arm, the left leg, the right leg. And then, in the head, we put in a separate layer. The eyebrows, the eyes, and each one of them has a name. Right eyebrow, left eyebrow. Right pupil, left pupil. You can name them in any way you want. Now, you can do this in either the Illustrator or Photoshop. Both work great. But I somehow feel that the Illustrator is a little bit better because it saves you a couple of steps in the After Effects when you want to turn the head and the other body parts. Now, this is the head and these are the pieces for the head. We have this eyebrow and the other eyebrow. Now we have this side of the face and the other side of the face. The eyebrows, the eyes, these are the pupils. Why would we want separate pupils? Well, because we want Jambu to look up and down and sideways and we can animate every single part of that. Then we have the mouth, the nose, and we have four mouths. I have the sad open mouth. I have the sad mouth, the sad open mouth, the natural happy mouth, and the natural mouth. Then we have the face. So, if we put it like this, we have a cool hairstyle. So that's the head. Now let's go for the body. We do this. That's pretty simple. Only put the neck there and then the head. Now that's simple. Now the arms. For the arms, we'll use four layers for each arm. And then the same happens for the legs. Now, let me explain this. We need the arm, then a copy of the body, then a copy of that same arm, and this line that's going to be covering the cloth. Right. So you can hide that line, like this. Okay? Why do we need to hide that line? Well, we don't want him to look like this, right? If you put the arm inside the body, we don't want this. It looks ugly. We need this, so we can do our technique called matte. And it's important for the body we need this. We need to hide this part of the arm. Okay? And then the same goes for the right arm. And the pockets. They go here. The way it's all going to be put together is like this. This is what we are going to bring to After Effects. Let me expand it so you can see. This is the body, and you can see the four layers for the right leg, then the four layers for the left leg, and then the pockets, the arms which need these four layers. Let me expand it so you can see. This is the body, and you can see the four layers for the right leg, then the four layers for the left leg, and then the pockets. The arms which need these four layers, like we saw earlier, then the neck, then the face, then all the properties of the face. Now it's important that we have the blinks hidden, so we can make him like here, blink, 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 and the hair is all the way to the back. Okay, so this is how it's going to look. From here, we will take Mr. Jambu to After Effects and make him mobile, make him animated, make his hands and legs and face and eyes and pupils move. That is the next step. Thank you.